Today, you're watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu. Over 20,000 people participated in the Yanshui Beehive fireworks display on the night of the Lantern Festival, which many worried may cause further spread of the epidemic. That's why the Tainan City government started providing rapid test kits from February 16th to 18th at the Yanshui District Health Center for the public to claim on a voluntary basis.
There are not many people in front of the public health center on the morning of February 16. Some are mainly there to pick up chronic illness prescriptions, but some are indeed there to obtain rapid test kits. The Yanshui Beehive Fireworks Festival just came to completion on February 15, with over 20,000 people on site. Although the attendees are all supplied with protective gears and enhanced personal COVID-19 prevention measures, because of prior confirmed case tracks reaching the nearby Yuejing Lantern Festival, and attendees may have come from all over Taiwan, the Tainan City Government Health Bureau decided to provide rapid test kits for all people in need, and expects to give out 1,000 rapid test kits in 3 days.
昨天那个港灯节的那个人证，还有那个风炮人，实在蛮多的啊，所以说今天开始就是无差别，所有人都可以来我们盐水卫生所这边来拿那个快筛试剂。
The Tainan City Government Health Bureau notes that from February 16 at 8:30 a.m. to February 18 at 10:30 a.m., anybody in need can obtain a rapid test kit at the Yanshui District Public Health Center. In case of a positive test result, patients should contact the Health Bureau. In addition, the Yanshui Beehive Fireworks Festival has come to an end early this morning. The Tainan City Environmental Protection Bureau dispatched 153 cleaners overnight to dispose of a total of 27.1 tons of fireworks debris and garbage, restoring the place to its original state before 8 a.m. this morning.
Another Taoyuan student tested positive for COVID-19 shortly after schools reopened. This student lives with his grandfather, a police officer working at Taoyuan International Airport, who previously tested positive. The student's kindergarten has suspended classes for 14 days, and over 300 students and teachers were tested.
Another Taoyuan student tested positive for COVID-19 shortly after schools resumed classes. On February 15th, a police officer at the Aviation Police Bureau headquartered at Taoyuan International Airport tested positive and was listed as case number 19763. His grandson, who lives with him, was identified as a contact and tested. The test came back positive. Taoyuan's Department of Education immediately notified the student's kindergarten, and classes were suspended for 14 days, and 331 teachers and students were tested, along with parents.
经过医疗狂烈之后，那么同住的家人哦，他的孙子哦，那么也这个验出阳性，那因此教育局早上就通知这个孙子所就读的幼儿园哦，进行全员的裁剪。几点接到学校的通知？8点多。啊，学校怎么跟你说的？
他说有人确诊。
啊，所以你们今天过来做什么？
就要筛检，现在是两个小朋友要带回去。对对对，刚筛检完。哦，刚筛检完了。那接下来要怎么处理？
就只能陪他们在家里。 The city recently revoked enhanced disease prevention measures, and its regulations are now in line with the central government's level 2 alert. Swimming pools and attached facilities, including saunas and steam rooms, have reopened. The provision requiring restaurants to cut their seating in half was also revoked, and karaoke equipment can be used again. Restaurant proprietors say business fell by 50 to 60% during the time the enhanced measures were in place.
对我们餐饮业来讲，应该也是一个好消息啦。不过我们餐饮业还是不能放松，我们还是会配合政府，然后做好10连制啊，然后酒精消毒，然后离开座位就必须把口罩戴起来。
Taoyuan City Mayor Zheng Wenchan said there are still unclear infection sources and health monitoring inside communities needs to continue. Testing sites at Zhonglu Park in Taoyuan District and Zhongzhen Park in Zhongli District will remain open.
Numerous photographers took their chances to capture the beauty of a very rare steam locomotive in Hualien, with one of them crossing over the fence to take pictures, leaving everyone there in a cold sweat.
This is the North Railroad crossing in Hualien Shoufeng Township, Zhixue Village. There were several railway fans crowded in front of the fence, taking shots of the fast-approaching whistling DT-668 train with the steam locomotive. However, a female in a pink coat disregarded the dangers and crossed over the fence to take her pictures. Everyone behind her was in cold sweat.
This is a very dangerous move. For the photographer, 是绝对不允许的，而且这在铁道的安全上面也会造成一个危害，也容易造成就是行车事故。
The Railway Police Bureau said that when the trains pass by, they create huge steam cyclones, to which, if people stand too close, the cyclones would draw in objects nearby. The act of such a female has violated Article 57 of the Railway Act and may be subject to a fine of 10,000 to 50,000 NT dollars. The female's identity has been confirmed, and she has been notified to report to the police.
在此呼吁民众。 平交道范围应保持健康，请于许可与安全范围进行各项活动，严禁进入平交道内拍照。
A senior railway fan emphasized that experiments abroad showed that when a train passes by with a speed of 50 kilometers per hour, it produces approximately 8 kilograms of momentum. This is Bernoulli's principle. Thus, there are yellow lines on train platforms to warn people not to underestimate the dangers caused by steam cyclones.
Earlier this month, a man in Taichung refused to take a breathalyzer test. The police responded by strictly enforcing the law.
On February 7th, a 37-year-old man surnamed Peng temporarily stopped his vehicle at a red curb in Taichung's Beichun District. He was flagged by the police. When he rolled down his window, the strong odor of alcohol flooded out. The police asked him to take a breathalyzer test, but Peng refused. The police fined him.
这要给我啦，规定啦。这宝贝，那这是大号哩啊！签收件。啊，你。无啦，我来讲，按到了开迄张尔啦，这拢。张尔，你贪了济啊，你要开。我就跟你讲，我无贪，我要闹贪。啊。The
police issued a 180,000 NT dollar fine to Peng for refusing to take a breathalyzer test. He also accused the police of profiting from this fine. According to the police, the legislature passed amendments to Article 35 of the Road Traffic Management and Penalty Act on January 24th. Previously, people who refused to take breathalyzer tests were issued a 180,000 NT dollar fine on the spot. Their vehicle was confiscated and their driver's license was suspended for 3 years. The amendments added an additional penalty, the suspension of the vehicle's license plate, for 2 years. An announcement will be made shortly regarding the amended law, and the police are also promoting it.
新法还有新的规定，如果驾驶人拒测的话。 除了吊销驾照三年之外，他的车牌要吊扣两年，所以这边在此宣导那个所有的用路人哈，切勿心存侥幸。The
Taichung police said once the amendments take effect, people who refuse to take breathalyzer tests will have their license plates suspended for 2 years. Anyone who continues driving with the suspended license plate can be fined up to 10,800 NT dollars.
Now, let's take a look at more international news today. Russia is starting to withdraw some armed forces in military districts near the Ukrainian border. The Kremlin spokesperson, meanwhile, said Western politicians are making up horror stories, hoping for a war between Russia and Ukraine. Heavy rain, flooding, and landslides left 23 people dead in the Brazilian city of Metropolis. Hundreds of firefighters and first responders have been called in to help. Runner Sha'Carri Richardson says she saw double standards when Russian skater Kamila Valieva was allowed to compete at Beijing despite testing positive for a stimulant. Richardson was dropped from Team USA after she tested positive for marijuana. Another Chinese military aircraft was spotted entering Taiwan's airspace, which flew at an altitude of as low as 30 meters.
Chinese military aircraft buzz Taiwan's airspace on an almost daily basis. Military enthusiasts said Chinese military aircraft entered Taiwan's southwest airspace on the morning of February 16th, and one flew at a super low altitude of 30 meters. It's believed to be a military helicopter, which made an appearance last year. The People's Liberation Army has been strengthening its amphibious landing capabilities. Military experts say to watch out for PLA Navy submarines covertly laying mines at western ports and deploying a carrier strike group along the East Coast, because these actions are war preparations. Experts also spoke about the timing of an attack, saying the PLA will complete combat preparations in the shortest time possible, including mobilizing troops and relying on civilian resources. It may commandeer vehicles, airplanes, ships, medical resources, and disaster prevention resources, as well as hold related drills. These are all indications that Taiwan will be attacked. The cross-strait situation remains tense. Some scholars say China won't develop the ability for an all-around attack of Taiwan within the next decade. Scholars say it's not likely that China will launch an all-around attack on Taiwan in the near future. Instead, it will use battlefield operations, hacking, and the three warfares to divide public opinion. It may even capture outlying islands to force Taiwan into negotiating.
Thank you for watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu, and I will see you next time.